Hello and welcome. What is CCleaner? CCleaner is the number one utility for cleaning your computer, protecting your privacy, and optimizing your system. CCleaner is available for Windows and Mac. CCleaner contains a powerful registry cleaner. It contains advanced features to remove unused and old entries, such as file extensions, ActiveX controls, class IDs, program IDs, uninstallers, shared DLLs, fonts, help files, application paths, icons, invalid shortcuts, and more. CCleaner is designed to be fast and efficient. Your online privacy is protected by cleaning your history files, temporary internet files, cookies, super cookies, form history, and download history. CCleaner is great for uninstalling programs that you can't uninstall from the control panel. CCleaner can also be used to disable certain programs from starting up when you boot your computer. Let's install CCleaner. Open a web browser like Internet Explorer. In the address bar, enter piriform.com, piriform.com, and press Enter. On the Piriform homepage, click Download, Download CCleaner. On the Download CCleaner installer page, click the link to download from Piriform. On the download information bar, click the Run button. This will download the file and then automatically start the installer. Once the download completes, the installer will start. On the installer language window, click the OK button. On the Welcome to CCleaner Setup Wizard screen, click the Next button. On the License Agreement screen, read through the license agreement, and then click the I Agree button. On the Install Options screen, deselect Add Open CCleaner option to the Recycle Bin context menu, and then click the Install button. On the Completing the CCleaner Setup Wizard screen, deselect both options, and click the Finish button. You can open CCleaner in one of two ways. Option 1, double-click on the CCleaner icon on the desktop. Option number 2, click the Windows Start button, All Programs, CCleaner, and then click the CCleaner icon. On the CCleaner Intelligent Cookie Scan window that opens, click the Yes Recommended button. CCleaner will open to the Cleaner tab. The Cleaner tab is used to search for and then remove both Windows and application data. You can analyze first, or just run CCleaner. Click the Run Cleaner button. It pops up letting you know that this process will permanently delete files from your system. Click the OK button. Now that the scan's complete, let's resize the window so we can see it a little better. Here we can see a list of all the files that were deleted. In my case, running this deleted 7,416 megabytes, or around 7 gigabytes. Let's click on the Registry tab. The Registry Cleaner will search for various unused information in the Windows Registry, and then allow you to remove it. Click the Scan for Issues button. When the scan is complete, you can view the various entries it found that were unused. You can review them if you wish, and unselect ones that you actually do want to keep. Or you can just click the Fix Selected Issues button. It'll ask you if you want to make a backup of the registry. You should always do this. Let me repeat. You should always backup the Windows registry. If something happens to your system as a result of this and it can't boot, you could then use that to restore the system, allowing you to boot again. Click the Yes button. Search for a suitable location, and then click the Save button. Now you can go through these one at a time if you want, but as you can see, I have 1,122 of them. So I'm going to just click the Fix All Selected Issues button. Once finished, click the Close button. Let's continue on and click on the Tools tab. There are four options available here. It'll open to the first, which is Uninstall. The uninstaller is used to remove unwanted programs from your system. You can first try and uninstall by clicking on the Run Uninstaller button. If this doesn't work, you can manually delete the files from your drive, and then use the Delete Entry button to remove it from the list. Startup. Startup is used to display the program set to auto-start when your computer boots, for both Windows and Internet Explorer. You can review this information to disable unwanted startup items. Disabling unneeded items will help your system boot faster in many cases. This can also point to a potential virus or spyware in your system. Let's review the items on the Windows tab. You will see the registry key that the startup item was found in, along with the name of the program, and the path to the file. Looking in the list, we can see there's an Adobe Reader Speed Launcher. This is great if you use PDFs a lot and you want the program to open faster. If not, it just slows down your system. I'll select the entry. It's probably best to just disable the items initially, and not just delete them. After you disable an item, you should reboot the computer and make sure that nothing bad has happened to your system, and then go back and delete the entries. I know I want this item gone, so I'll click the Delete button. The item has then been removed from the list. Let's click on the Internet Explorer tab. Here you will have a list of extensions, toolbars, and helpers set to auto-start with Internet Explorer. Looking in the list, we can see the Search toolbar. I will never use this, so I'll delete the entry by clicking the Delete button. Let's click on the System Restore tab. The System Restore tab contains the Windows restore points created on your computer. System restore points help you restore your computer's system files. System restore points help you restore your computer's system files to an earlier point in time. You can delete old restore points to free up disk space if you like. Drive wiper. When you delete a file from your computer, even if you empty the recycling bin, Windows only removes the reference to the file on the disk. It does not actually delete the data on the disk. With the right software, someone would be able to reconstruct all or parts of the files that you deleted. Drive wiper assures that nobody can recover deleted files by overwriting deleted files with new data preventing recovery. You need to be extremely careful with this tool. You could accidentally delete important files with absolutely no way to recover them. In the dropdown next to wipe, there are two options. Free space only. This option will leave all your files intact, but will write over the free space on your system to prevent deleted files from being recovered. Entire drive. This option will erase your entire drive, including all files. This option will not work on the system drive usually see. In the security dropdown, you have four options. The default is Simple Overwrite, 1-pass. The rest of the options contain additional passes. 1-pass means that the files are overwritten one time. 3 times means they were overwritten 3 times, and so on. Some people feel that more passes make the data more deleted. According to the National Institute for Standards and Technology, most of today's media can be effectively cleared by a single pass. I would recommend keeping it set to single pass. Select the drive you want to overwrite, and then you would click the Wipe button. You should now have the basic information needed to use the various features available in CCleaner.